فؤادك الأيام فتى.
إن شاء الله تعالى تتمة للفائدة. I'm going to inshallah ta'ala finish off or mention some benefits regarding the topic that we were talking about, which is unity upon the haqq and how the kitab has prohibited on the sunnah and the actions of the pious predecessors to come with disunity. This issue that we really need to know, which is inshallah a tatimmatun, is a mas'ala, a point that is important and it's really needed. And it's one of those matters, yajibu ala talib al-ilm, a student of knowledge, it is needed at this time, an yata'ammalha, that he observes this matter right now. It's very important. And it is, ma hiya as-sifatu. And the issue is, what are the characteristics? Allati tasiru al-firqatu biha mukhalifatan lil-firqati al-najiyati al-mansura. What is it, or what is the characteristics that will make a group in opposition to the safe sect? What are the characteristics that will make a group, or even individuals, in opposition to the saved sect in which we were told to follow or to be from them? Al-Imam al-Shatibi rahimahullah, Abu Ishaq al-Shatibi in his kitab al-I'tisab, which anyone who can read Arabic should look at and benefit from this great book by this great Imam, Al-Imam Abi Ishaq al-Shatibi, rahimahullahu ta'ala. Al-Imam al-Shatibi, his speech is very long, and I'm going to read it, inshallah, bituliha, in its length, and I'll explain it, inshallah, ta'ala. Before I read it, I want you guys to understand it, and I will give you an overview of what he's going to say, and then I'll explain it word for word. Al-Imam al-Shatibi says, rahimahullah, that a group will be in opposition to the saved sect if they go against them in a ma'nan kulliyin fi ddini. Fi ma'nan kulliyin fi ddini. If they oppose them in a matter which is what? A matter that is a fundamental issue in which the religion stands on. And that is two things. منهج التلقي, أما مصدر التلقي, the source in which we take our religion from is a معنى كلي في الدين. If a person says to you, and what is the مصدر التلقي عند أهل السنة والجماعة؟ الكتاب والسنة وإجماع سلف الأمة. The kitab, the sunnah, and the unanimous consent of the pious predecessors, Ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'in, and their understanding. There are groups that went against this. What did they say? We give our intellects and logic precedence over the kitab and the sunnah. These people, have they gone against Ahlul, this group, did they go against Ahlul Sunnah in a ma'an and kulli? Yes, they did. Also, there are groups that have put before the kitab and the sunnah, what did they put before it? Like the Sufiyah, they put dhawq, their senses, before the kitab and the sunnah. Manamat, his dreams, he will extract rulings from that. Over the kitab and the sunnah. Anything he feels that brings him ruhaniyah, spiritual enlightenment, it's legislated now. And he will give that, his feelings, precedence over the kitab and the sunnah. Na'am. And the issue of logic, which I mentioned, Fakhruddin al-Razi, Ibn Taymiyyah refuted in his book, Dar'u Ta'arud al-Aql wal-Naql, when he mentions the issue of his argument of At-Ta'arud bayna al-Aql wal-Naql, when the Aql and the Naql, the text and the logic go against each other, he mentions points, four points, and finally says that the one we should take is that logic takes precedence over the text. And that's what governs it. Those are the two. The third ones that we have today is people give politics. Siyasa. Politics, they give it precedence over the kitab and the sunnah. Instead of going back to the kitab and the sunnah and making that their reference point and the ijma' of the salaf of this ummah, what do? Politics. The current situations of the Muslims and their politics that are taking place takes precedence over the Kitab and the Sunnah. All of those are turuq. They are way and paths which go against firqatun najiyah, the safe sect. And that individual, he becomes what? He becomes a sect that is not part of the safe sect. And from them are those people like the tabliq. The tabliqis, they are a group mukhalifatan lil firqatin najiyatil mansura. They oppose what? They go against the safe sect. In a what? In an issue which is ma'nan kulliyin fi ddeen. Because these issues, brothers, if we say them and we don't give examples, people won't understand. They need to understand a group that they can say which ones. From those groups are also what? Hizb al-Tahrir. They go against Ahlul Sunnah in what? Fi ma'nan kulliyin fi ddeen. They're Ahlul Bid'ah. They are not from firqatul najiyah, ta'ifatul mansura. They are mukhalifatan lil firqatul najiyatul mansura. They are in opposition towards it. From them is Ikhwanul Muslimin. Ikhwanul Muslimin are what? They are in opposition to firqatul najiyah fi ma'nan kulliyin fi ddeen. They go against Ahlul Sunnah. And those are ala sabili tamthili lal hasr. It's just an example. Doesn't mean those are the only groups. There are many more. Also, what falls under ma'nan kulli is not only masdar al-talaqi. Also, if you go against Ahlul Sunnah in these five issues that we always bring back, which is masailul asma'i wa sifat, the names and the attributes of Allah, if you go against Ahlul Sunnah, I'm a firqatul najiyah, the way Ahlul Sunnah believed it, you don't take the tariqatul mushabbiha, or you don't take the tariqatul mu'attila, those who say Allah's characteristics resembles the characteristics of the creation, or they make it equal to the characteristics of the creation, you don't take that path. And you don't also take the path of who? The ones who dismantle Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's characteristics in which he has affirmed for himself. The second issue, Ikhwani, is, so in that point, the Jahmiyyah, the Mu'tazila, the Asha'ira, all of them, they're firqah who went against Ahlul Sunnah in what? In a ma'nan kulliyin fi ddeen. They go against Ahlul Sunnah. The Maturidi and all of them. The other thing, Ikhwani, is the masail pertaining to what? Masail al-qada' wal-qadr. The qada' and the qadr. The qadariyatul mujbira and the qadariyatul nufat. They went against Ahlul Sunnah in this issue. And we expanded on that in our book, Aqidatul Raziyain. And we also expanded that on in our Lamiyatu Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah, rahimahullah ta'ala, and in also the other books that we taught in Aqaid. The third one is, مسائل الأسماء والأحكام, the names and the rulings, such as مسألة الإيمان, that you don't take the طريقة الخوارج, who believed what? أن الإيمان لا يتجزأ ولا يتبعض, that إيمان is something that is present, it's either there or it's gone, it can't be broken into an أصل and a فرع, that the إيمان, the Salaf, what did they mention? Muhammad Nasir al-Marwazi in his kitab تعظيم قدر الصلاة, Ibn Manda, rahimahullah, in Kitab al-Iman. When they mentioned Iman, what did they say? Illa anna lahu aslan wa far'a. That the Iman has asl. That if you don't come with, your Iman doesn't exist. And it has far'a, sub-branch. Ahlul Sunnah, that's what they believe. That the Iman yatajazza. And in Iman, yatajazza. That Iman could be broken into asl and a far'a. The Mu'tazila, what did they say? The Mu'tazila believe, they brought this issue which is منزلة بين المنزلتين. If a مرتكب الكبيرة, a person commits major sin, he's not a believer nor is he a Muslim. He's not a believer nor is he a disbeliever. So what is he? منزلة بين المنزلتين. A station between the two. What about in the hereafter? In the hereafter is in the hellfire. إذن فوافق الخوارج. So ولذلك the علماء, they say خلاف that is between the معتزلة and the خوارج is a خلاف صوري. I'm a خلاف لفظي. Just the wording is different. But in reality, the result is the same. They both believe that you're going to stay in the hellfire forever. Just one calls you a kafir, another one calls you anonymous, question mark. There's no different. They both believe in the hellfire, you're there forever. The murji'ah, another deviated sect who went against Ahlul Sunnah, who believes what? That the person, if he comes, لا يضر الكفر مع الطاعة. That the kufr cannot harm once you've come with obedience. And once you come with Islam, you can come with kufr if you want, you can say anything you want. The same way, ta'a, obedience, does not help you once you're a kafir. If a kafir gives sadaqah, or he fasts, or he prays, would that be accepted from him? Not at all, because the kufr won't allow that. So they said the opposite holds truth. If you're a Muslim and you come with kufr or disbelief, they said it won't harm. And so they went against what? Ahlul Sunnah in this issue. They went, so the person, and they believe that the iman لا يزيد ولا ينقص. The iman does not decrease or increase. Because again, the iman لا يتجزع عندهم. It doesn't, you can't break the iman up. So for them, every person in the iman were the same. There's no decreasing or increasing. Your iman and the iman of Jibreel and our messenger and Abu Bakr and Umar are all the same. The iman doesn't increase nor does it decrease. So they came with khubth and filth. And they took the actions out of iman. Ahlul Sunnah, they refuted their maqala and their statement. So this is Masail al-Asma'i wal-Ahkam. Kufr is also from those issues as well. Ahlul Sunnah believe that the kufr is what? There are matters which are kufr duna kufrin. Actions which the person will leave. يُنَاقِذُ أَصْلَ الْإِيمَانِ. And they believe that there are actions which are matters which are kufr. يُنَاقِذُ كَمَالُهُ الْوَاجِبِ. So Ahlul Sunnah believe that. So that's مسائل الأسماء والأحكام. You can't go against Ahlul Sunnah in this issue. If you do, you become a firqah مخالفة that opposes طائفة المنصورة. I'm a firqah الناجية. The fourth one is الوعد والوعيد. The promises and the warnings that have come in the Quran, you have to place them in the places that the Quran and the Sunnah have, and that you don't follow the paths of the deviated sects pertaining to that. And last but not least, the issue of the Sahabas, which is the fifth one, Masail al-Sahaba, the matters pertaining to the Sahabas. You can't oppose Ahlul Sunnah in what? In this issue, you cannot take Ali ibn Abi Talib, like the Nusayriyyah, who said that Ali ibn Abi Talib is ilahu yu'bad. They worship Ali ibn Abi Talib as though he's an ilah. That's kufrun billahi al-Ali al-Azim. They took Ali above his status. And you're not like those who done takfir of Ali ibn Abi Talib, like the Khawarij, who done takfir of Ali ibn Abi Talib, and they done takfir of Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and they wanted to get closer to Allah. Like the man who al-Imam al-Shatibi rahimahullah brings in his kitab al-Itisam, and a lot of the ulama, they mention it, that Abdurrahman ibn Muljim, who killed what? Abdurrahman ibn Muljim, who did he kill? He killed, what's his name? Ali ibn Abi Talib. Abdurrahman ibn Muljim. He killed who? A man, a khariji, khabith, filthy khariji, by the name of Imran ibn Hittan. His name is what? Imran ibn Hittan. He praised Abdurrahman ibn Muljim. He was praising who? Abdurrahman ibn Muljim. And this is what he said about him, about when he killed Ali ibn Abi Talib. He said, "Ya darbatan min taqiyin ma arada biha." He said the hitting of a pious individual. Ma arada biha, he did not intend in his hitting of Ali, illa liyablugha min dhil arshi ridwana, except to reach the pleasing of the Lord of the throne. When he killed Ali ibn Abi Talib, he only did that for no other intention. There was nothing else in his heart. He only did it for what? He only did it to get closer to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and Jannah, and to Allah to be pleased with him. Then Imran ibn Hittan, look what he said. Inni la adhkuruhu yawman fa ahsibuhu. He said, I remember him at times. And then I think to myself that he is awfal bariyat inda Allah mizana. That he is the most obedient individual in the scale of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, in what he did. This is killing who? Killing Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And then Imam al-Shatibi said about him, كَذَبَ لَعْنَةُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ. He lied, may Allah's curse be upon him. He killed Ali ibn Abi Talib and he wants to get closer to Allah by it. And then these usul, and they're also عَلَى سَبِيلِ التَّمْثِيلِ لِلْحَصْرِ. These are ru'us. Many issues come under these ones. Many issues come under it, which inshallah ta'ala we're going to tackle them. But all of the masail al-aqaid, you can squeeze them in these five. That's the first point. Shatibi rahimahullah ta'ala, when he mentions that a person will be in opposition to the saved sect if he goes against them in a what? في معنى كلي في الدين, in a fundamental principle. And we mentioned two things, مصدر التلقي and أصول, these five issues. نعم, we mentioned those two. They fall under the fundamental matters which you can't go against Ahlul Sunnah regarding. Now, the second point now. The second, first one was what? في معنى كلي في الدين, matters which are principles in which you, in the religion, that's the first one. The second one that will make a person a innovator and it will take him away from the path of the saved sect is if he comes with juz'iyat, a lot of sub-branches. Now it's not a kulli. It's not a kulli, it's juz'i. He comes with so many sub-branches. They come together, so much of them, they come together, this person would be what? He will be like a person who came with a kulli. Because what's the difference between that and a kulli? The kulli was what, brothers? If you're listening to me and understanding what I'm saying, the kulli, it brings so much sub-branches, right? And the person's already come with so much sub-branches. The kulli, the comprehensive principle, kulli is a comprehensive, a lot of sub-branches fall under it. But now, he's already come with a lot of sub-branches. Ahlul Sunnah consider him a mubtada, and he becomes a deviated individual, and a person needs to understand that. So now, inshallah, that now that you've understood what Imam al-Shatibi is saying, I'm going to explain it, inshallah ta'ala. I'm going to explain it. Al-Imam al-Shatibi rahimahullah said, إِنَّ هَذِهِ الْفِرَاقَ إِنَّمَا تَصِيرُ فِرَاقًا بِخِلَافِهَا لِلْفِرْقَةِ النَّاجِيَةِ فِي مَعْنًا كُلِّيٍّ فِي الدِّينِ وَقَاعِدَةٍ مِنْ قَوَاعِدِ الشَّرِيعَةِ لا في جزئي من الجزئيات إذ الجزئي والفرع الشاذ لا ينشأ عنه مخالفة يقع بسببها التفرق الشيعة وإنما ينشأ التفرق عند وقوع المخالفة في الأمور الكلية لأن الكليات تقتضي عددا من الجزئيات غير قليلة وشأنها في الغالب ألا تختص بمحل دون محل ولا باب دون باب واعتبر ذلك بمسألة التحسين العقلي فإن المخالفة فيها أنشأت بين المخالفين خلافا في فروع لا تنحصر ما بين فروع عقائد وفروع أعمال ويجري مجرى القاعدة الكلية كثرة الجزئيات فإن المبتدع إذا أكثر من إنشاء الفروع المخترعة عاد ذلك على كثير من الشريعة بالمعارضة كما تصير القاعدة الكلية معارضة أيضا. الإمام الشاطبي said إن هذه الفرق these groups إنما تصير, it will become, these groups, they will become a group بخلافها للفرقة الناجية, in opposition to the saved sect. في معنى كلي, in a comprehensive fundamental issue of the religion. وقاعدة من قواعد الشريعة, and a principles from the principles of the religion. لا في جزئي من الجزئيات, not in a sub-branch from the sub-branches. Now he's going to tell us why. Because the sub-branch وَالْفَرْعُ and the sub-branch أَشَّاذُ, that's separate, stands by itself. لَا يَنْشَوْ عَنْهَا مُخَالَفَةٌ يَقَعُ بِسَبَبِهَا تَفَرُّقُ شِيَعًا. Because a sub-branch that stands alone does not establish or initiate opposition that causes division and disunity. It doesn't. وَإِنَّمَا يَنْشَأُ التَّفَرُّقُ, but disunity occurs عند وقوع المخالفة, when the opposition is in what? في الأمور الكلية, in a comprehensive fundamental matter. لأن الكليات, because the comprehensive fundamental matter تقتضي عددا من الجزئيات غير قليلة, it brings under it so many sub-branches which are not little. وشأنها في الغالب, and it is a lot of the times ألا تختص بمحل دون محل, that is not specific to a particular issue than another issue. Because the comprehensive issue, what does it involve? Many chapters that fall under it. It doesn't just, it's not exclusive to only one chapter. And ولا باب دون باب, and not one particular chapter over another chapter. And then he gave an example. واعتبر ذلك بمسألة التحسين العقلي. And take into consideration, for example, in this issue, the matter that the Mu'tazila came with, which is the issue of tahsin al-aqliyain, the issue of that which the brain and the logic of the person, what it sees to be good is good or not. And we mentioned that issue in Qawa'idi al-Fiqhiyya when we were talking about it. He gave that as an example, because this one right now is a ma'an and kulleen fi deen. Why? How is it? فَإِنَّ الْمُخَالَتَفَةَ فِيهَا. Because taking this issue and opposing Ahl Sunnah in this issue, أَنْشَأَتْ بَيْنَ الْمُخَالِفِينَ, it resulted in the opposition of those who opposed Ahl Sunnah in this issue, خِلَافًا فِي فُرُوعٍ. So many sub-branches came because of this. It caused a harm to so many sub-branches. So much, this issue, under it fell so many sub-branches that the Mu'tazila used, that they brought under this branch. في فروع لا تنحصر, in which you can't even put a number to it. ما بين فروع عقائد وفروع أعمال, and that فروع, those sub branches are not only عقائد issues. No, rather even matters of fiqh. And we study قواعد الفقهية. ويجري مجرى القاعدة الكلية. And now he's studying another thing now, the second one, which I told you. ويجري مجرى القاعدة الكلية. What also takes the ruling of the قاعدة الكلية, the comprehensive principle. What also takes it is what? كثرت الجزئيات. If the sub-branches are a lot. Which is the second one. فَإِنَّ الْمُبْتَدِعَ, because the innovator, إِذَا أَكْثَرَ مِنْ إِنْشَاءِ الْفُرُوعِ, if he initiates a lot of sub-branches, الْمُخْتَلَعَةِ, in which he introduces, he innovates and he starts, عَادَ ذَلِكَ, that matter will come back to what? عَلَى كَثِيرٍ مِنَ الشَّرِيعَةِ, it will come back to a lot of the sharia, the legislation. بِالْمُعَارَضَةِ, in opposition. كما تصير القاعدة الكلية معارضة أيضا. It's the same as the comprehensive principle. Because the comprehensive principle, so much things fall under it. It goes against the Sharia. When so many branches come together, it will cause opposition towards the Sharia. So a person become a mubtadi' because of it. So this is a point I think that is very important that we understand it. نعم.
الأصل الثالث, إن من تمام الاجتماع السمع والطاعة لمن تأمر علينا ولو كان عبدا حبشيا, فبين الله هذا بيانا شائعا كافيا بوجوه من أنواع البيان شرعا وقدرا. ثم صار هذا الأصل لا يعرف عند أكثر من يدعي العلم, فكيف العمل به؟
The Sheikh says, "Inna min tamam al-ijtima'i, from the completeness of unity is as-sam'a, to listen, wa-ta'a, to obey, liman ta'ammara alayna, anyone who takes leadership over us." So this asal is the third asal, it's the third principle. And it talks about what? As-sam'u wa-ta'atu liman ta'ammara alayna, to listen, to obey anyone who Allah gives leadership over us. وَلَوْ كَانَ, even if he is, وَلَوْ كَانَ, even if he is, عَبْدًا, a slave, حَبَشِيًّا, a Abyssinian slave. فَبَيَّنَ اللَّهُ, Allah clarified, هَذَا, this هَذَا goes back to what? السَّمْعَ وَالطَّاعَ لِمَنْ تَأَمَّرَ عَلَيْنَا, to listen and to obey anyone who Allah gives leadership over us. Allah clarified that. بَيَانًا, a clarity, شَافِيًا, that is, أَمَشَائِعًا, That is spread. Kafiyan, that is enough. Biwujuhin, Allah did it in many different ways, the way He told us. Min anwa'il bayani, from the types of clarifications. Shar'an, by way of legislation. Wa qadaran, by universal evidences or clarifications. Thumma sara hadha al-aslu, pay attention, this is a very important point. ثم صار, and it became, هذا الأصل, this foundation, this fundamental point, it became what? لا يعرف, it is not even known. عند أكثر, with who? With a lot of من يدعي العلم, a lot of people claim knowledge. A lot of people who claim knowledge, this principle is not even with them. فكيف العمل به? How would knowledge, how would implementation be with them? Even if the knowledge isn't with them, فكيف العمل, how is implementation going to be there? They don't even know it. And wallahi brothers, this is أصل من أصول أهل السنة والجماعة. It's a fundamental matter from the fundamental issues of Usul Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Are you with me? And a lot of people who claim knowledge, they are ignorant of this issue. So how can we expect them to implement it? And as we're all aware of, is annasu a'da'un, that the people are enemies of what? Ma jahilu, that which they are ignorant of. If you're ignorant of something, you show enmity and hate towards it. And this is Shaykh al-Islam, Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, rahimahullah, clarifying this issue for us in this small book of his. And this issue, brothers, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in some of his hadith, which we're going to come to inshallah ta'ala, in the sharah of Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen, and Allah tabaraka ta'ala, he clarified it in the Quran as well. But inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to bring you the hadith narrated by Imam Muslim in his Sahih. An Wa'il al-Hadrami. Wa'il al-Hadrami, he said, Wa'il al-Hadrami, he said, I asked. Qala sa'ala, sorry, Wa'il al-Hadrami said, سأل سلمة بن يزيد الجعفي. سلمة بن يزيد الجعفي asked the messenger. سأل سلمة بن يزيد الجعفي asked رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. He asked the messenger. فقال يا نبي الله. He said, oh messenger of Allah, أرأيت إن قامت علينا أمراء. Oh messenger of Allah, how about if leaders, we have leaders that are leading us, يَسْأَلُونَ حَقَّهُمْ, they ask us their rights. They want their rights from us. وَيَمْنَعُونَ حَقَّنَا, and they prevent from us what? And they don't give us our rights. All they want and they're demanding all the time is their rights. And when it comes to us getting our rights from them, they don't give us our rights. فَمَا تَأْمُرُنَا, what do you order us, O Messenger of Allah? What should we do in this situation? The leader, all he's saying is, give me my rights, give me my rights, give me my rights. But when it comes to him having given us our rights, he doesn't do that. The messenger, when Salamah ibn Yazid asked him this question, the Prophet turned away from him. And then he asked him. فَأَعْرَضَ عَنْهُ, the Prophet turned away from him. And then on the third time he asked him, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam turned away from him. When he done that, Ash'ath ibn Qais, he فَجَذَبَهُ الْأَشْعَث ibn Qais. Ash'ath ibn Qais pulled him. And then he replied, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, اسْمَعُوا وَأَطِيعُوا, listen and obey. فَإِنَّمَا عَلَيْهِمَا حُمِّلُوا وَعَلَيْكُمْ مَا حُمِّلْتُمْ. Upon them is that which the burden that they have carried. They will be questioned for it the Day of Judgment. And you guys will be questioned for what you have taken. Listen and obey him even in that situation. It's unfair to you. Huh? Even in that situation where he's unfair to you and he's unjust, listen and obey. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he also told us in a hadith Imam Muslim narrated, from who? Arfaja, he said, I asked the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said I heard the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, I heard the messenger say, innahu satakunu hanatun wa hanatun, there is going to be hanat and hanat. The word hanatun, hanatun is jam'u hanatin. It's the plural of what? Hanatin. And hana is used tutlaqu ala kulli shay. You can use it for anything. And here the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he meant fitna. There's going to be fitna. There's going to be matters, fitness that are going to take place. Pay attention to this. فَمَنْ أَرَادَ, anyone who wants. أَنْ يُفَرِّقَ أَمْرَ هَذِي الْأُمَّةِ, anyone who wants to break the unity of the Muslims. وَهِيَ جَمِيعٌ, and they're united upon a leader. They have a leader who controls them. فَمَنْ أَرَادَ, anyone who wants. أَنْ يُفَرِّقَ, he wants to break the unity of the Muslims. أَمْرَ هَذِي الْأُمَّةِ, the affairs of this ummah. وَهِيَ جَمِيعٌ, and they are together. under a leader. فَضْرِبُوهُ بِالسَّيْفِ. Smack that person with a sword. كَائِنًا مَنْ كَانَ. Whoever that person is, doesn't matter. Whoever that individual is, has to be killed. So what does that hadith show us? Anyone who goes against a Muslim leader, he should be killed. And he wants to break the kalimatul muslimina, the unity of the Muslims. Even if that leader is a transgressive leader. And that is ijma'u ahli al-ilmi min ahli sunnati min ulama'ina. Rahimahumullahu. May Allah have mercy upon all of them. This is a unanimous agreement from the ulama of ahli sunnah wal jama'ah. They unanimously agree upon that anyone who tries to go against a Muslim leader, even if he's a fasiq, that the Muslims would side with the leader and they will fight with that baghi, that in that rebel, they will fight with him, with their leader. It's a unanimous ijma'. And it breaks what? It breaks the unity that the Sharia calls to. It breaks the unity which the Sharia calls to. So brothers, are we going to leave that which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said? Are we going to turn away from it based on people's what? On people's khutbah, their khutbah which they do that are emotional and eloquent. Is that what we're going to choose over the statement of the Messenger? What did the Prophet tell us here? There's going to be fitan. Trials and tribulations are going to take place. But the Prophet told us, alayhi salatu wasalam, anyone who tries to benefit from that by breaking the Muslims who are united upon a Muslim leader, anyone who tries to go against him, that rebel will be fought against, and it doesn't matter who he is.